about a girl named Heidi. When Heidi was only 1 year old, her mother and father died, leaving her in the care of her older cousin named Dee. After 4 years went by and Heidi turned 5, Dee had to go away to take a job in the city of Frankfurt. So Dee left Heidi in the care of her cousin, of her grandfather, who everyone called an uncle. After Dee left Heidi in the care of an uncle, Heidi began to talk to an uncle, and at the end of the day, she was delighted to find out that he wasn't mean to her. The very next day, Peter the goat herd came over up the mountains to take an uncle's goats and graze. When Heidi saw the goats, she immediately wanted to go with Peter up the mountain. Grandfather agreed and let Heidi go with Peter. She soon found that she loved the mountain, and she picked hundreds of flowers that day while playing with the goats. For a week, the same pattern went on, with Heidi staying with uncle for the rest of the day, and in the morning, she would go up the mountain with Peter. After a week went by, Peter told Heidi that she wanted her to meet his grandmother, who she also called grandmother. So soon, right after Peter invited her, she went down the mountain to grandmother's house and met her. Grandmother was blind. She had been blind for over 20 years. But when she met Heidi, she said that Heidi brought joy to her life and she almost made her able to see again. After 3 years went by and Heidi turned 8 years old, her cousin named Dee came back up the mountain to collect Heidi again. She came to collect Heidi again because the people that she worked for required a companion for their daughter named Clara, who was 12 years old. Heidi believed that she would only leave the mountain for a few days to visit the city of Frankfurt, when the truth was that she was left, but she was leaving for perhaps forever. When she reached Frankfurt, she soon became immediate friends with Clara and the manservant named Sebastian. But soon after a few weeks, Clara and Sebastian noticed that something was terribly wrong with Heidi. She was becoming very sick, the rosiness left her cheeks, and all the healthiness that she had gained while living on the mountain was gone. So they called for the doctor. The doctor told everyone that Heidi's only chance of recovery was to go back home to the mountain, where her homesickness would be cured. Clara wept at the thought of her new friend leaving her, but she was soon comforted when her father told her that he would visit Heidi on the mountain the very next summer. As Heidi was supposed to leave, Clara's father came to visit her and say goodbye. He also told her that she may have anything that she wanted as a remembrance of her friends from Frankfurt. Heidi told Clara's father that all she wanted was a basket of the white rolls that they ate for dinner every night. He agreed, but he asked her why. She said that it was because her grandmother back at home hated the black bakery bread that they had to eat, and then she thought that maybe if grandmother could eat the good white rolls, she might be able to see again. Clara's father was very touched and agreed to let her have the rolls. When she went back to the mountain, she immediately went to grandfather, who was overjoyed at her return. And the very next day, she went back down the mountain to visit grandmother. She gave grandmother the rolls, and grandmother was filled with joy when she saw them, when she felt them. And she said that perhaps she would be able to get more healthy now. Heidi also had another gift for grandmother. She had learned how to read. For over 20 years, grandmother had not been able to read her favorite book of hymns, but now Heidi said that she would read them to her, and this is the hymn that she read. The morning breaks, and warm and bright, the earth lies still in the golden light, for dawn has scattered the clouds of night. God's handiwork is seen around, things great and small, to his praise abound. Where are the signs of his love not found? All things must pass, but God shall still, with steadfast power, his will fulfill. Sure and unshaken is his will. His saving grace will never fail. Through grief and fear, the heart assail over life's wild seas. He will prevail, joy shall be ours, and may God bless. Where after storm, we find our rest. I wait in peace, God's time is best. Grandmother was overjoyed when she heard the hymn, and for the remainder of Heidi's visit, she begged Heidi to read the different hymns over and over again. Soon, another year had gone by, and it was summer, the very summer in which Clara had promised to visit. Soon, Clara came up the mountain with her grandmother, whom Heidi called Grandmama. Clara was very overjoyed to see the mountain, because she thought it looked exactly as she thought it would. She loved being there with Heidi, and to Grandmama's amazement, she ate the food there that she had eaten no other food. She ate it almost as if she was starving, but she took such delight in it. Grandmama was very surprised because back home in Britain, Clara never ate any of the food there. So Grandfather was watching Clara, and he told Grandmama that he thought if Clara would stay on the mountain for a month, she might be able to get better. Grandmama agreed and left them on the mountain. The very next day, Peter came up the mountain with the goats, and he asked Heidi if she would be going with him up the mountain again. She said no, because she wanted to be there and spend time with Clara. Peter was very angry, and when Heidi went inside, he saw Clara's wheelchair standing outside by the edge of the mountain. Clara had to ride in a wheelchair for the rest of her life because she was very sick and she was not able to walk. So he thought that maybe if he destroyed the chair, she would not be able to walk and she would have to return back home to Frankfurt. So he shoved the mountain down the hill where it broke into a lot of pieces. Clara was very sad when she came outside and found her chair was gone because she thought that she would surely have to return back to Frankfurt. Grandfather replied that was not so, and for the next few days, he and Heidi helped Clara learn how to walk. Soon, she was able to walk almost as well as Heidi herself was. When Grandmama came up the mountain to see how Clara was doing, she saw Clara walking just as well as Heidi. She was filled with joy and immediately called her son, Clara's father, come up the mountain. He came to go up the mountain, and he saw Clara standing there, looking identically like her mother had, walking almost as well as any other child could have. He was overjoyed at seeing her in her health, and he told Grandfather that anything that Grandfather wanted would be his, because he was forever his debt for helping his little Clara get better. Grandfather told him that there was nothing that he wanted, he had everything that he needed, but he only wanted one thing, which was the promise that Heidi would never have to make her living among strangers, and that she would never be alone or without family. Pierre Sussman, who was Clara's father, agreed and said that they would never even dream of leaving Heidi alone. When they finally went down the mountain to visit Grandmother one more time, she told Heidi, "Heidi, read me one of the hymns. I feel I could do nothing for the remainder of my life but thank the Father in heaven for all the mercies he has shown us."
Thank you. This is our last song. We are going to say goodbye after this song. But thank you so much for having us. And the song that I'm going to sing is called The Blessings. And I don't know how you feel about us, but we're so blessed to have you guys here and that we are able to perform for you. And thank you so much for allowing us to come here and share this moment with you guys. So this is the song, and I hope you enjoy. Thank you.
When